you find out about Nofitstate Circus?
I came last year for another show which was really quite spectacular.
I was really impressed by the fact that it wasn't just happening on the stage, it was happening in, around, and above you.
And what sort of expectations do you have about today's show?
Well, I was most excited about somebody walking on a tightrope in stilettos.
And what do you expect from today's show?
Something different, because it's not your typical circus. Something awe-inspiring, a bit amazing, maybe intriguing, maybe a bit scary.
Cunningham for Tightwide, and I'm here with Kate, who's a performer in the Nofitstate Circus. What made you want to perform in the circus?
It just looked quite exciting, and I did gymnastics when I was a kid, and I remember starting to see circus at festivals, you know, looking at the trapeze thinking, oh, I could do that. And then the first time I got on a trapeze, it was really difficult, and I was like, oh my god, I'm gonna have to work my ass off here.
How long have you been in the circus?
I've been with Nofitstate for about 9 years now. I saw them nearly 18 years ago and decided that was the circus I wanted to be part of. One of my main roles in the circus is a tent master. I'm actually responsible for getting our big top up and taking it down again safely.
I've got quite a complicated role. I'm the sort of the producer and the tour manager. Coming here, huge challenge for us, very exciting, but the first time we've ever taken our show out of our tent and brought it into a building.
Here at the Roundhouse is the biggest audience we've had. Normally in our tent we'd accommodate perhaps up to 450 people.
The Roundhouse, I think, at 650. You know, moving through the crowd is difficult because there's more of them, but that's great. You know, the more people, the better, really. The show works better with a big audience. But it's also really exciting to be in that venue.
I love the way the rigging works in the show as part of the performance. 5 years ago when we created this show, no one was doing anything like it.
What exactly do you do in the act?
I'm a character in the show. I get up on ropes.
The show is so full on.
When you have to move from one place to another inside the building.
You have a route around that space that has to be very well planned.
You've got to weave your way through and around the crowd.
You have to wear harnesses at certain points, so you have to know where your harness is, and then you'll have a costume change.
I'll be up in the air one place and then up on the stage over at the other side, you know, literally 10 seconds later.
Are there any personalities which just really clash with each other?
Of course. You have your professional life and then you have your personal life, and it's really hard to kind of separate the two things when you're on tour. But if you've just had a barney with someone and you're really upset about that and then you have to go into the tent and do a show and you're suddenly finding that you're counterweighting that person, you cannot let any of that personal stuff come into it.
Every day those guys are putting their lives in each other's hands, you know, they have to have complete and utter trust.
Trust is that two-way thing, you always have to earn it.
You rely on each other, you put your lives in each other's hands all the time. So it makes you sort out your differences quite quickly, really.
We have currently got new performers that we're still learning to trust, and you know, you have to build it, you have to work on it, and then you have to earn it from each other.
If you're having issues, personal issues with people, you leave it at the stage door. That is just, you know, the nature of being a professional in the business.
Total trust in one another, because without it, your lives are on the line, and so it really, it does bond us quite strongly, that. But like I say, you have to earn it.
while we're a contemporary circus, the setup that you see here is very trad, in that circuses have travelled around in big tops and lived in caravans and all that kind of stuff since they started, really.
What do you think makes Nofitstate Circus so unique?
Nofitstate Circus is a circus, but it also encompasses a lot of different art forms. The band are a massive part of that. There's video and there's singing, there's the physical theatre.
What do you think of the Roundhouse in general as a venue for your circus?
It's fantastic for our circus.
The show really works in there.
So it's fantastic to be here. I love it. It's what a great space.
So I'll take my hat, my coat, and say goodbye with mine. Then you go to... In a sense, you go back to the chorus.
Hi, I'm Dave Gamble. I'm here for Tightwire TV. I'm lucky enough to have Serge from the band from Nofitstate with me. So you play double bass in the band. How do you find playing with a circus, playing two artists?
I've been playing with artists for more than 15 years. So playing with the circus is completely different. The music support, the performers. So it's not really about you, about the musician, it's about the performer first.
What's your favourite part of the show?
The trapeze, yeah.
The trapeze?
Yeah, the trapeze, yeah.
Have you got any particular skills circus-wise yourself? Do you know how to juggle or tight wire walk?
I don't know anything about
it. We're here with the musical director and accordion and keyboard player of the Nofitstate Circus. So, Peter, how do you find the show tonight?
It's getting better. It's getting better.
How much more difficult is it to write a piece of music that goes with a live performance?
I kind of specialise in playing to live performance or to physical performance. So that is what I do, that is my kind of skill. There's a greater freedom just playing with a band or an orchestra, because then you just concentrate on the music. Like here you're continually shaping the music to the scene. You have to dramatise the music in a different way, and there's more room for the music. First of all, one has an idea, a thematic idea from the director, and then I write lots of music with the musicians with no thought about the show. We then come into show mode, they are rehearsing and we're playing pieces, and sometimes she'll come in and say, hey, that piece, I like that piece, let's try it to a certain physical event, and we rehearse it into the show live. Our job is to make them look brilliant. Make them look brilliant, whatever the situation. So they give us a sense of timing. Like when Gareth comes on his rope. So that's a new piece to a new situation. But I'm still trying to make it happen so that as he descends, I descend with him and we punctuate. Lynn is, as she's doing her swinging, she throws this red shawl so for someone to catch. And I will put in something, if I got time, in the accordion that actually comments on that falling. It's very light, and it's gone, and one person will notice it and someone else won't. There's lots of little details like that, you know.
Well, thank you very much. I've enjoyed the show all week long, and the music is an integral part of it, and I think it's brilliant. And thank you very much for talking to Tightwire.